Hello and welcome to the last session of Waveguide. In this session, we're going to discuss about microstrip and equation of power. So before going to start about the microstrip line, let us discuss the basic things required for understanding the microstrip. So initially days, we're going to transmit our signal from transmitter to receiver through coaxial cable or through fiber optics. Now, what is our main goal here is that we have to transmit our signal in form of electric field and magnetic field from transmitter to receiver. So this is another mode of transmission of electric field and magnetic field, that is using microstrip. So before going to start actual concept, let us understand what is the advantage of microstrip over coaxial cable. So if you see the advantages directly, then we can observe that it is a low cost as compared to coaxial cable, and it is very small in size and easy to attach on dielectric material, easy to access and measurement. These are the four advantages which plays a crucial role for developing a microstrip line. So disadvantage here is that high radiation loss, yes, and there will be a discontinuity in the electric field and magnetic field. So the designer should have to look after these two cases. Once if they overcome this one, then I can say that this is one of the best way of transmission of signal from transmitter to receiver with low cost and small size. So let us start its discussion of its construction, then let us go for the principle. So if you observe this, the construction, you have to understand three things here. That is, we have a conductor, and that is very important. We have a dielectric and we have a ground. So this is H represents height. This is nothing but T. This is nothing but T represents thickness. W represents the width. And this, if it is in circle form, then it has some diameter. So let me discuss the following parameters: height, thickness of a conductor, width of the conductor, and there will be a diameter of a conductor. So these are the things that has to be understood. Now this is a conductor where we are going to give some input. With this input, because of that conductor, there will be a generation of electric field and magnetic field. So magnetic field will revolve around like this, and electric field will go in this fashion. Now the question is that, sir, what is exactly advantage of this using? So I've discussed several advantages, but one of the best advantage you just observe here is that this is nothing but your width, and this is nothing but your W dash. That is, W is width of physical width. This is physical width, and W dash is a logical width. So what is the concept behind? If you see any object, it is maybe a physical, but if you see from the far, then it will almost look like big. So maybe it's a joke, but try to understand again here the same logic. If you design this is the width, then from the outside it will look like in this fashion. So the same thing I'm going to make you to understand here. If this is your width, because of this radiation, all radiation, this whole conductor is got, I can say that it is not visible, then only the radiation is visible. So because of the small width, we have a lot of radiations, and this radiation from, if you see from the outside, it will looks the width as this much. So this is, you have to understand, I repeat, this is your actual width. If you see from the outside, because of its radiation, it will look like the width of this one. So what you have done, if you are used 2 cm as a physical width, it is converted into 6 cm. So what happens during transmission and reception? So there will be a conductor, then as the distance increases from transmitter to receiver, you have to increase your conductor length also. But if you see here, if I use a small conductor as a microstrip, there will be a radiation. Then what I have to do? I have to use a conductor after certain distance. Again, there will be a radiation. Then after this certain distance, again, you have to use a... So what happens means, if instead of using 100 centimeter, maybe I'm going to use only 30 centimeter. Only 30 centimeters. So instead of using 100 centimeter, I'm going to use only 30 centimeter in the form of microstrip. So what happens means, the cost is reduced. Then because of a smaller size, it will have efficient transmission of signal. So from this slide, I want to conclude that because of this W width, physical width, and because of this logical width, there is an improvement in the width, which reduces the cost of the material also. So this is what you have to understand. So next thing is that we have discussed this one, and this is the normal thing. So we have the conductor, substrate, and ground. Now, as you know that we have to find its impedance, its dielectric. So this is your impedance that has to be remembered for designing of microstrip line. And you know that diameter of wire and H is at height. So there is a condition that height should be far greater than the diameter of wire, that is a conductor. Here wire indicates a conductor. Now the next thing is that relative dielectric constant. This topic is referred with respect to the substrate. So substrate has some dielectric. It has to be given with some formula matic. Now this is nothing but W epsilon R is nothing but effective dielectric constant, and epsilon R, this is an epsilon R, this is a relative dielectric constant. So what is the diameter of the wire? What is the phase velocity? You try to remember all this formula while designing a microstrip line. So next, this is nothing but the relation between the whatever we have understood about impedance, then the diameter, width, relative permittivity, height, thickness. So this is the formula. Try to remember it. Now what you have understood here is that almost you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 formulas that has to be write in the exam. Now this is the different types of microstrip. We have learned one of the type, then you can say that this is your conductor and it is embedded in the microstrip. So inside that microstrip we're going to use our conductor. Then we have flipped version. We have used here a dielectric then conductor, here first dielectric then conductor. It's a flipped version. It's called as inverted microstrip. And this is nothing but a slotted. We have used a two conductor. And then next you have suspended microstrip. So we have four types of microstrip that can be used for your transmission. Now we have discussed these two already. Now the last topic is your equation of power. So in that we're going to understand about the power generated in TE and TEM mode. So now if you go basics, the power is defined in the transmission line or electromagnetic waves through Poynting theorem. So what is the assumption is that once the signal is transmitted, there should be no reflection. That is called as no reflection from receiver end. That is an assumption. It's a pure ideal condition. So power transmission is given by integration of P into ds. That is, we're going to take a small surface, we're going to find the power here, and we'll integrate to find the overall power transmission. So sometimes it can be written as voltage into current or voltage dot current. So instead of using the voltage, you're going to use electric field and magnetic field. That is a replacement of voltage and current in the form of electric and magnetic. It's not exactly true, but try to understand in this fashion. As you know that power is nothing but V into I. So now for the lossless dielectric, the time average power to the rectangular waveguide. So now we are going to focus on of rectangular waveguide. So what is the power transmitted in the rectangular waveguide? So this is a almost similar thing of power is nothing but V square by R, or power is nothing but I square by R. Now this is your impedance. So ZZ is given a EX by HY minus EY. Already we have discussed this one. And the next one is that what is your electric field square can be written in this fashion also. Already I've discussed all these things in the impedance. Now the last topic is about what is the power transmitted in TM mode and TE mode. For that, this is not your interesting impedance as 277. So this is the formula that you have to remember for your finding the power transmission in TM mode and TE mode. I hope you have understood about this importance of microstrip line and the power transmission. So this is your end of the session. So I'm going to post you the problems based upon that. I request to all the students that it's better to understand first theory, all the theory first. Definitely there will be a formulas, and that formulas has to understand practically. So instead of going direct problems, it's not easy tasks to solve the things. So students, I request you better you go for all this topic first, then solve the problems. In the next videos, I'll going to keep the problems based upon these topics. Thank you.